springs, clean springs, are extremely complex, diverse ecosystems. Now, that doesn't mean everything's diverse. Like I said, the plant communities are typically dominated by one or two macrophytic plants, but those plants are actually the home to extreme diversity of algae, naturally adapted algae that live in springs, which are then the food for this diversity of insects, and aquatic beetles, aquatic dragonflies and damselflies, mosquitoes, not so many in springs, salamanders, damselflies, you know, mayflies, stoneflies, aquatic hemipterans, diving and water bugs, and snails. I mean, just incredible complexity of species. And thank you, Steve Walsh, for these pictures. And Dr. Odum was really the first person to recognize that, and he wrote a landmark paper on Silver Springs in the 50s, and he developed ecological modeling from that study he did, and this is a later rendition of his model that was determined from the data that he collected. But it turned out Silver Springs was this incredibly adapted machine, if you want to give it a dirty word. It was a machine that had evolved over millions of years. The complexity in Silver Springs was like a tropical rainforest or a coral reef, which we all read about how complex they are. Silver Springs' productivity was equivalent to those other ecosystems, those supremely adapted ecosystems, in terms of how much useful production was coming out of these plant communities. And it's because there was abundant light and the water was clear all the time, and there was abundant nutrients naturally in the aquifer without our adding more to them. And in fact, there was abundant water. And those are the three main things of life, is you need light, water, and nutrients. And so Silver Springs are extremely productive. And he quantified that. Silver Springs, where it looks like the waving grasses are not growing at all, is what the riverboat guys would say. You know, these grasses never grow. They're always here. Well, it turned out Dr. Odum found out they were turning over eight times every year. They were completely replacing their biomass eight times every year, which is an incredible level of productivity. When you put it on, like, compare it to a cornfield, it was more productive than a cornfield, you know, that's being fertilized. And that supports this food web. A complex food web where the consumers, these top consumers, are regulating the fish and the insects, which are regulating these herbivores, which are regulating the plants. It's a beautifully adapted system. Anything gets out of whack in a beautifully adapted system, it's like trying to tune up your own Ferrari. It becomes a mess when you start messing with any of the parameters that go into this. And that, unfortunately, is what we're doing now.